Why didn't you put us? I don't know. Why didn't you put us?
Ladies and gentlemen, Panache, special pleasure in presenting Miss Cynthia Crane.
Under the stars, a winding stream. be here at Panache. This is my first time. And there are two things that I love about this room. The first one is the man who runs it. You know, this man is indefatigable. He has more energy than anyone I know. And he's a joy to know. And on top of everything else, he himself is a terrific performer. And the other thing that I love about the room is that it's Cabaret Month all year round. Yeah? Well, you know, we just finished Cabaret Month. The month of March is officially Cabaret Month in New York City. How many of you knew that? Well, now you know.
Nobody can.
Actually, March has another totally different meaning for me. Every year it rolls around, I get another year older. I just had a birthday. And you know how it is, when your birthday comes, you start thinking about improving yourself. I'm really into self-improvement in a big way. So that's why I like these next two songs. That I trace every day. Patterns as I say the things I always say. Patterns in the ceiling as I lie awake. Why are patterns haunting every move I make? Just look, here I am on cue. Again, upset, feeling torn in two. Again, afraid, saying I'm okay, making little jokes till I run away. Again, and yet today I am not the same. I feel my life slipping from its frame. Strange feelings safely away again. Patterns that begin as I walk through a door. that lead me nowhere. you ever make, have wishes well, or wedding cake comes true. I feel sorry for you. And if one day your ship comes in and fate decides to let you win the prize, I could honestly sympathize, for happiness could never make you happy. You find contentment only in a frown. And when your lucky star is on the rise, you turn your back and shut your eyes. When things are looking up, you're looking down. You could win the sweets, win the daily double two, and hit the number on the notes. Be on all the big game shows. Come out smelling like a rose. You could win the set of matching luggage. You could win the Acapulco cruise. But still you'd lose, 'cause you would rather have the blues. Yes, you would rather have the blues. And on your tax return, you could write off all you earn. And when the final buck is spent, the bank would tell you, skip the rent. You don't owe us one red cent. You could be the first to holler bingo. You could be the last to hear bad news. But still you'd lose, 'cause you would rather have the blues. Yes, you would rather have the blues. Dollar bills could float down from the skies. Luck is what your name personifies. Anyone given half a chance to choose would choose to be in your shoes. But still you'd lose, 'cause you would rather have the blues. Yes, you would rather have the blues. You could have your cake, and you could eat it too, and never have to pay the freight, never have to watch your weight. Dress size, a perfect eight. You could have a dozen world-class lovers waiting in romantic rendezvous. But still you'd lose, 'cause you would rather have the blues. Yes, you would rather have the blues. You could get a break. Hollywood would call, and you could be out for a big star, and other stars from near and far would know exactly who you are. Businessmen would pop for business lunches, offering you deals you can't refuse. But still you'd lose, 'cause you would rather have the blues.
Okay. Well, you know, this next song,
was written by a lady who lives up in Boston. I keep wishing she'd write a lot more music because I love this song. I've been doing it so long, I think I'm pretty soon gonna have to take it out of my act. But I love it too much, so it's in. And I've put it with two songs by Irving Berlin. How is your wife? I seem to ask you whenever I see you alone. And how are the girls? My, what a lovely photo. Don't they look fine? My, what a pair. Where did you plant? How's the bank? How is your house? Did the mortgage fall due? And how is your wife? Sometimes I feel her near me, part of my dreams, out of the blue, part of my part. Thank you. Tropics. Just give me palm trees, you know, soft tropic breezes, blue Caribbean waters. It doesn't even have to be in color. It could be in black and white. Put me in Key Largo. Big wooden bladed fan over my head, rain drumming outside the beat, beat, beat. When I was growing up, there was one person that I wanted to meet. And this is in a time we're talking Churchill, Roosevelt. You know. I wanted to meet Arthur Godfrey. I wanted to meet the man who introduced the world to Holly Loki and the ukulele and Hawaii. That's how you say it, Hawaii. So, against the advice of just about everybody I know, I am going to sing this next song. Oh, yeah. That's good enough for government work. Now, actually, I have every right to sing this song, I want you to know, because I've actually been to Hawaii. And I want to tell you that everything they say is true. It really is paradise, and I would very much like to go back. I want to go back to my little grass shack in California. Want to be with all the connies and bahinis that I knew long ago. I can hear those guitars a-playing on the beach at Haumau. I can hear the Hawaiian saying, Kama mai no ka wai ka haere vele ka hau. It won't be long till my ship goes sailing back to Kona. A grand old place that's always fair to see. Boy, I wanna go everybody tasted poi. I want to go back to my little grass shack in Kaka'ako, Hawaii, where the hula hula loopa loopa wapua I go swimming by. Where the hula hula loopa loopa wapua I go swimming by. I'm getting the blue Pacific. song was written by a gentleman who was my first musical director when I came back to Cabaret, but more important for me, he helped me make the transition back from producing in the off-Broadway theater arena, the Impossible Ragtime Theater, back to Cabaret, which was my first love, because I used to sing in nightclubs when I was up in Boston. I didn't tell you, but Sydney and I share an alma mater. We both went to Emerson. So, I don't want to tell you that it wasn't the same year. I won't tell you who went first. But anyway, it was Peter Fish who wrote this next song, and I'll sing it. The crime just doesn't pay. Don't tell me you won't do it again, 'cause you have done it again today. Yes, I know you've been playing around, but there's gonna be hell to pay. 'Cause what's good for the goose is good for the gander. If you can carouse, then I can meander. If you're gonna play the field behind my back, you're gonna find me running on a faster track. And I need to say I told you so, but I told you so. And I never will say never, but I'll never come round no more. And I'd like to think you did not know, but I know you know. 'Cause I told you so at least one time before. Little white lies are like blueberry pies. They both taste sickly sweet. Too much of either is hard to digest, 'cause you are just what you eat. And you're gonna eat a lot of crow and some humble pie before I go, because I'm not just another between meal snack. Something to munch on when the hunger attacks. If you're only gonna want me when the pickings get lean, I'll be out there dining on some pork cuisine. And I hate to say I told you so, but I told you so. And I never will say never, but I'll never come round no more. And I'd like to think you did not know, but I know you know. 'Cause I told you so a couple of times before. And my memory ain't exactly what it should be, oh no. But I do remember when you said I'll always be there for you. And my love life ain't exactly what it could be, oh no. But it's gonna get much better, 'cause I am saying goodbye to you. So don't ask me for one last chance, I've given you that before. And don't appeal to my sense of romance, because romance is such a bore. And don't tell me we'll always be friends, 'cause I know what friends are for. And with friends like you, who would need a foe? Oh yes, just one more thing before I go. Well, I'm pretty sure that I have said it before, but I will say it again, just so you'll know the score. But I hate to say I told you so, but I told you so. And I never will say never, but I will never come round no more. You did not know, but I know you know, I know you know, I know, because I told you so. At least one time, oh yeah, I told you so. A couple of times, oh yeah, I told you so. A thousand times or more. No, honey, I told you once, I told you twice. Mama ain't gonna tell you. Funny thing about songs, there's so many composers that I love. Rogers, Richard Rogers and Hart, you know, and Harold Arlen is one of my favorites. Jerome, Kern. But as I look at the material, Jack Whiting, absolutely. As I look at the material, singing, here I am singing yet another song by Kern. Richard Whiting.
He said it.
He said it.
I just read it.
Anyway, this is yet another Kurt Weill song. And we wrote this one with Maxwell and
I like that.
I've been running through rains, and the wind that follows after. For one certain face and an unforgotten laughter, I've been following signs, I've been searching through the lines for a certain pillar of arms and a certain pair of hands. Yes, I try to kiss here, and I try to kiss there. For when you're out in company, the boys and girls will fail. But it never was you. It never was anywhere you. An occasional sunset reminded me of a flower hanging high on a tulip tree, or one red star hung low in the west, or a heartbreak call from a meadowlark's nest made me think for a moment, maybe it's true. I found him in the star, in the calm, in the blue. It takes people about 2 minutes after they've met me to get the information that I am a native New Yorker. I'm really obnoxiously proud of that fact. And one of the things that I remember best about growing up in New York City, believe it or not, is the New York City subway system. It was really terrific. It was a nickel. And for 200 miles of track, you could ride accident-free, graffiti-free, no fires. You know, it was terrific. But one thing has lingered to this day, and that is the spirit of the men. And I'll tell you why. Subways come, and subways go. To some, it's all a game. And the men who drive those grimy cars are seldom known to fame. But they do their best, in spite of all, with glory in their hearts. For when their spirits start to fall, they can think of Mervyn Schwartz. says, on the east side, IRT. They said his train was slow, boys. They laughed right in his face. So Mervyn challenged the BMT to a midnight subway race. The train was pretty old, lads, as old as it could be. He was up against the very best of the Brooklyn BMT. But he slammed the doors at Union Square and threw the throttle wide. And he shouted to his passengers, by God, you're going to get yourselves a ride. There was fire along the tracks. They whizzed right by the local stops. There was no turning back. They whizzed right by the local stops and Mervyn screamed with glee, we're gonna beat the record of the Brooklyn BMT. The passengers were panic-struck. Their hearts were filled with fear. They knew when they passed Bloomingdale's that the end was almost near. And though they tried to stop it, word never got around. For right after they passed Bloomingdale's, they passed the Speaker's sound. Now 86 had come and gone much quicker than a week. And up in front of Plum Urban saw that the train was on the blink. The train was going faster, although the lights were red. The train was going fast as hell on the broad straight ahead. Was convenient, very. For at the end of the line of the IRT sat Woodlawn Cemetery. Now, wherever the subway workers meet, at the bar or the MBA, they speak of good old Mervyn Schwartz and the way he passed away. They speak about the record set on that famous, fearful day. And they say, by God, that Mervyn Schwartz was subway all the way. And if there's a subway heaven, and I don't doubt there is, I know that good old Mervyn Schwartz is up there getting his. Oh, the train may be a bit too clean, but it's lettered for all to see. Mervyn Schwartz, conductor of Heaven's IRT. To the delightful gentleman at the piano, my partner in crime. We've been working together for about a year now. We started together a year ago during Cabaret Month, and he adds a lot of color and texture to my music, and I'm really grateful to have at the piano Mr. Bob Goldstone. As long as I've got your attention, I would like to make a public service announcement. And the public service is me. You see these little cards on your table? If I haven't corralled you and gotten you onto my computer, I'd like to do it tonight. So please, feel free, fill them out, and I guarantee you'll hear from me. So I'd love it if you would do that. Mae West once said, When choosing between two evils, I always choose the one I've never tried. When I was young and simple, I don't recall the date, I met a handsome captain of the guard. He visited my chambers one evening very late, in tandem with a husky Saint Bernard. At first, I was astonished, and tears came to my eyes. But later, when I asked him to resume, he said, to my surprise, "My dear, it isn't wise. Where love is concerned, one must freshen the bloom. Once, yes, once for a lark, twice, though loses the spark. One must never deny it, but after you try it, you vary the diet," said my handsome young guard. "Yes, I know that it's hard still, no matter how nice. I never do anything twice." I think about the Baron who came at my command and proffered me a riding crop and chains. The evening that we shared was meticulously planned. He took the most extraordinary pains. He trembled with excitement. His cheeks were quite aglow. And afterward he cried to me, "Uncle!" He pleaded with me so to have another go. I murmured caressingly, "Whatever for." Once, yes, once for luck, twice the loses the spark. Once, yes, once is delicious, but twice would be vicious, or just repetitious. Someone is bound to be scarred, and mine know that it's hard still. No matter the vice, I never do anything twice. And then there was the abbot who worshipped my feet and dressed me in a wimple and in veils. He made a proposition which I found rather sweet and handed me a hammer and some nails. In time, we lay contented, and he began again by fingering the beads around our waists. I whispered to him then, "We'll have to say amen," for I had developed more Catholic once, yes, once for luck, twice, though loses the spark. As I said to the abbot, "I'll get in the habit, but not in the habit. You've my highest regard, and I know that it's hard still. No matter the price, I never do anything twice. Something to do, totally new, I will be there in a trice. But I never do anything twice, except... No, I never do anything twice."